Hi, it's Yaakov Hotter from gypsyandjazz.com, and in this lesson I want to talk with you about Django Reinhardt's minor swing recording from 1947. I will show you something great, amazing, that you can learn from it, and how much important it is to transcribe solos of the big masters like Django Reinhardt, and how much you can learn from transcribing other guitarists' solo. So you'll be able to hear the complete solo in the end of this lesson, but let's start with the beginning. 1, 2, 3, and. So what is the most important thing we can learn from this phrase, from the beginning of the solo, from these 8 bars, to improve your playing? Well, the most interesting thing here is not the notes that he plays, is the idea of taking a motif of 4 bars, all right, and repeat it twice. How many times do you do this in your improvisation? And the motif is a melody. It's a beautiful melody. It's not just running over the arpeggio. How often do you do this in your improvisation? So I will show you how to implement this to your improvisation in a minute. But first, let me show you how to play the phrase so you'll be able to play it together with me. You bend from the 11th fret to the 12th. And then on the 3rd string from the 9th fret, you play the notes of E on the 9th fret, D on the 7th fret, and C on the 5th fret. And then half tone below, and you jump to the note of F on the 2nd string. That note relates to D minor. 1, 2, 3, 4, bend, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and 2, and. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and 2, and 3, 4. The second sentence starts the same, with the same bend, but now you have an ornament. I showed it to you in my previous video. You are on the 10th fret on the 2nd string, and you play down on the 10th fret of the 2nd string, up on the 12th fret, pull off, and down on the 9th fret. Down, up, pull off, down. So we had a bend. And on the 3rd string, you have this melody with the notes of F, E, D, D, C, E on the 10th, 9th, 7th, and 5th frets on the 3rd string. 1, 2, 3, embellishment. 2, 3, 4, 1, and 2, and 3, and 4. And all together, first sentence. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and 2, and 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And now the second sentence. 3, 3. So what can we learn from this beautiful sentence? Well, the notes, which degree are, it doesn't really interesting here. What's really interesting is the form of this phrase. The solo starts twice with the same motif. In the second time, slightly variation, but it's the same thing. It's like A. We have in the improvisation parts, A part, and again A parts with a tiny variation. And it changes according to the chords. So you need to play phrases that you can change them according to the notes of the chord. The first phrase is of A minor, and we are going to the note of E, and we finish on the note of F, because then the chord of D minor arrives. three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. All right. The second phrase goes to the note of G, E7, because we are in the chord of E7. So you have F sharp, the harmonic minor scale, descending harmonic minor scale that finished on A minor. So the first thing I want you to do is to take this pattern and try to improvise with it your own sentences. Start like Django with the same note. And create new melodies that are similar to Django's one. So this is very close to what Django played. Now try to get further and further away. Okay, it's not exactly the same rhythm, but the way Django composes his phrase gives me the option to play my own four bar sentences, which is not something that maybe I already did a lot in my improvisation. All right? It's a different sentence. It's not something that Django did, but it's a new tool for me. And I can use it in every song that I want to play. And this is something new that I didn't play before. The thing is that when you play like that, you don't look at the music from below. What are the notes that I need to play? What chord am I? No. This is now you are in a different level. You look at the music from above. And you compose your sentences in four-bar sentences that changes according to the melody. And gives you something new and a new inspiration for your own solo. Let's see how I can implement this over a different song, like Dinah. Dinah, it's the chord of G, A minor, E7, and G. Here. So it's something that I wouldn't have played before. One, two, three, and. So this is a great exercise for improvisation, to improvise in sentences that you know ahead what the sentences are. Now when I improvise on stage, it's not something that I want to sing of. I want to flow, you know, I want to create, I want to be spontaneous. But if I practice like that, it gives me the opportunity not to sing on the chord each time, but to understand deeply in my heart the essence of playing in shapes. See the solo as a composition, and it leads you to play much more melodic and interesting in the footsteps of Django Reinhardt. There are so many great things to learn from this solo. This solo is so musical. There are many forms there, like we learn now A and A, two sentences. Every chorus has a different composition, A, B, A. A-A-B-A, A-B-B-C. So many ideas that it is amazing to adapt them and implement them in your improvisation. I see it on students of mine that when we work like that on improvisation, it doesn't matter what skills they have. With the skills they have, even if they are very low-tech skills, they can sound so much better when they improvise because they start to understand the essence of improvisation as a composition, as a music creation, and not just playing licks over and over again. Even if you take licks, but you know how to arrange them inside shapes, musical shapes, then your improvisation is in a completely different place. And that's what you like so much when you listen to the big master. In the next lesson, I will show you how to create an AAB form in your improvisation with octave. So stay tuned for the next lesson. And if you want to get the complete tools for improvisation from this solo and learn all this solo note by note slowly, improve your technique, your sound, your improvisation tools, and get a lot of bunch of licks that I will show you how to transform them to be your own from this solo of Minor Swing by Django Reinhardt, so check out my complete course. I'd love to read your comments below and see how do you think about learning to improvise like that, thinking in sentences and not in just licks and arpeggios. Cheers. Thank you.